The recent earthquake that jolted the Southland is sparking concern and highlighting a much smaller but potentially more threatening fault line. The fault, running from the Pasadena area to Puente Hills, has been very active in recent months.
KTLA's Rachel Menitoff has more from Highland Park.
Angelenos felt the jolt, the shaking of a 4.4 magnitude earthquake this week.
It felt like a basketball.
Some put their earthquake drills to good use and sheltered underneath kitchen tables. This latest one originated from the Puente Hills Fault, which is 25 miles long and runs from Glendale to Pasadena to Puente Hills. It's been really active in recent months, much more so than in past years. And its location near apartment buildings, homes, and businesses is concerning.
It has the potential for a very large earthquake. It's been modeled up to magnitude 7.5.
The issue of retrofitting is coming back to the forefront. In 2015, the LA City Council voted to require certain older buildings to undergo retrofits to make them more resilient. Owners had until 2023 to make those changes. According to analysis from the LA Times, there are currently 6,000 buildings potentially in need of earthquake updates in LA County. KTLA consumer expert David Lazarus says luckily, technology and infrastructure has improved enormously over the decades.
Buildings that go up now will simply be safer than buildings that went up, say, 20, 30 years ago. So that's an element to all of this. At the same time, make no mistake, it's a roll of the dice. If you're planning to spend millions or billions of dollars on a new project, you know full well there could be a catastrophe around the corner.
For comparison, 1994's Northridge earthquake killed 57 people and caused tens of billions of dollars in damage at a magnitude 6.7. Now the USGS estimates that if Puente Hills fault line produces a full rupture, damage could top $252 billion. Hundreds of thousands of people would be displaced, and anywhere from 3,000 to 8,000 people could die.
Through the Northridge earthquake, so, you know, the first thing I said is, I think the big one's coming, guys.
Judith Goldstein, the owner of Luca Natural Goods in Highland Park, remembers the progression of smaller quakes leading up to a very destructive one.
I know that this is the signs that a bigger earthquake is probably going to come. I mean, I hope I'm wrong. It passes us, but it usually, that's how it was before the Northridge earthquake.
Seismologist Dr. Lucy Jones says she hopes these smaller tremors are a reminder that a larger quake can strike at any time. Being prepared, she says, doesn't just mean having supplies stocked up like water. It's also really important to have a plan in place with your family and friends. Reporting from Highland Park, I'm Rachel Menitoff. Back to you in the studio.